Hi! Today we will be talking about named tuples. Named tuples were introduced as an experimental feature in Scala 3.5, and then they were stabilized in Scala 3.7. This handy feature fills the gap between the unnamed standard tuples, which are straightforward to use, but they are essentially just bare hard-coded sequences of fields, and case classes, which need some more ceremony, but are much more robust. With named tuples, you can give each field a name, so you no longer have to use dot underscore one, dot underscore two, and so on to access them. Plus, you don't have to rely on the field usage and type to know what they are about. A named tuple, however, is still just a tuple. No new classes are declared, keeping the bytecode simpler and reducing allocations. Yet, I was a bit skeptical at the beginning to use named tuples. I really appreciate all the extra functionality that case classes offer, especially seamless pattern matching. But what won me over is the IntelliJ IDEA support for named tuples, as well as one more Scala plugin feature that was introduced alongside them. We will talk about it later in this video, so stay tuned. Let's start with an example. First, we declare the type person tuple as a tuple with a string called name and an int called age. Then, we create the value Bob with the age set at 33. We can use name tuples on the fly without a type alias, like this, or even in function return types. But using a type alias makes your code much more readable. One thing to note is that, in theory, you could have multiple named tuples in your codebase with the same field types, which can make type inference in IntelliJ IDEA a bit tricky. Let's see what happens when I create another person, Alice, who is 50 years old, and then make a list of persons that includes both Alice and Bob. If I ask IntelliJ IDEA to infer the type, it correctly identifies the list as a sequence of person tuple. IntelliJ IDEA won't complain if I add Janice to the list, since her tuple has the same sequence of field types. But if I add another field, like hair color of type string, IntelliJ IDEA will highlight an error. This error occurs because the list of persons is explicitly declared as list of person tuple, and Janice's type is different due to the additional field. However, if I remove the explicit type declaration for the list and let IntelliJ IDEA infer it, we get something like this. This is because IntelliJ IDEA assumes the list is correct and tries to infer a type that covers all elements while being as precise as possible. The resulting type might not be what you intended, but hey, maybe it is. Now, for each person in the list, we can do things like print a message using the names of the tuple fields. For example, we can print person.name is person.age years old, like this. Or we can expand the tuple right there. Similarly, we can expand the tuple directly when working with a single value. Now, let's create a method called register that takes a person tuple. It doesn't matter what this method does. Let's just imagine it registers a person in some kind of data storage. What's interesting is that we can now call this method for Alice and Bob, and we can also create a new named tuple on the fly. You can think of a named tuple as if it were a case class with synthetic apply and unapply methods. If you have a case class in your codebase that you're only using for simple data storage and extraction, you might want to consider switching to a named tuple, as it's more lightweight. Now, if I try to pass Carl's age as a string, IntelliJ IDEA will highlight this as an error, because the parameter type is known to be person tuple, which expects an int for the age. Also, note that I can use code completion to quickly fill in the values for the named tuple, like this. I used this feature earlier when I specified the tuple fields for Alice and Bob. Just like with unnamed tuples, you can extract only some fields and ignore others by using an underscore. But named tuples offer another approach. We can tell the compiler that we are interested in only some fields by simply naming them. Let's write persons dot for each, colon case, parenthesis, name, equal sign, n, and parenthesis. This way, we state that we want to extract only the field called name from the named tuple and assign it to a new variable called n. IntelliJ IDEA recognizes this assignment, allowing us to use n in the println statement. Not only can we create new assignments, but we can also use this syntax for pattern matching. If I write case, parenthesis, name, equal sign, Bob, IntelliJ IDEA will recognize it and there won't be any error messages. For Bob, we'll get it's Bob printed out, and for Alice, we'll get it's Alice. Of course, this isn't limited to anonymous functions passed to methods like forEach. We can do the same in a match case expression. This solves an old problem. Before named tuples, when working with tuples that contained many fields, you had to use an underscore for every other field or reference the tuple followed by the underscore and the field index, even if you only needed one or two fields for pattern matching. Thanks to the new syntax, we can now clearly specify which fields we are interested in by simply naming them in the case line. That's great for tuples, but what about case classes? For years, we faced the same issue. If we wanted to pattern match on an instance of a large case class, we had to use one of those two old solutions. The slight advantage was that in the second solution, we could use the actual field names we wanted. Let's look at an example. As you can see, we can now destructure case class instances just like we do with named tuples. This is possible because the synthetic unapply method for case classes has been rewritten. The old unapply method returned an unnamed tuple. But the new one returns a synthetic named tuple. It works something like this. Or like this. And since we get a named tuple in the match case expression, we can use the same pattern matching features on field names that we use with named tuples. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching. To learn more about what IntelliJ IDEA can do for you, check out the other videos on our channel, and don't forget to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. You can also read our blog or chat with the development team on our Discord server. All the links can be found in the description of this video. Happy developing!